Well, welcome along to the SK Shielders SK Telecoms Championship. Ben Jacobs with you for an intriguing final round, of which we are already six or seven holes in as far as the leading contenders are concerned. And as you can see, the overnight leader, who's led from start to finish so far, Rihai Ran, is level par for the day, having just dropped a shot at her last hole, and that gives her a two-shot advantage, with one or two movers coming from behind in these early stages to cause what might prove to be a dramatic finish. In particular, Pak Ju-young, who is one under for the day, having birdied the sixth, and that was a swing, therefore, of two shots at that particular hole, because she made a birdie and Ryu made a bogey. And that makes things very interesting as we head towards the halfway stage of this final round. There is Park Hyung-kyung, and she is currently tied for third, coming off the back of a round of 69 yesterday. And there's Jang Ha-na as well, who is in contention too and in some really good form. Two under for the day, with birdies at the sixth and the seventh. The seventh in particular, the par three, is a good scoring opportunity. Probably the best chance of a birdie as far as the par threes are concerned. And here is the seventh. And as you can see, 17 birdies. It has taken its prisoners as well with 52 bogeys. But the wind is far milder than in the previous 2 days. And today the seventh has played very well for the leaders. We've only seen one dropped shot amongst all the field so far at this particular hole. As for our leader, Rihai Ran, she began with a birdie at the first, and that will probably play the easiest hole on the course. Nobody dropping a shot at that hole within the field. Here's Pak Ju-young, tee shot at the seventh. And she's just pushed that left. Not too much green to work with a difficult pin to the front left of the green. And that's up and down for par. Looked at one point after four or five holes like Rihai Ran might run away with it. She was on nine under and the rest of the fields were on five, four or less. And that would have proven to be a very healthy advantage. But the last hole really turned things on its head. Now Ryu protecting a two-shot lead. Here's Lee Go-young. And that is right at the pin. 5-footer for birdie. Brilliant tee shot. Really aggressive. Got a good bounce. And then because the green slopes down, nice opportunity to pitch it in short and then let the ball and its roll do all of the work. So a first look for us at the leader, Ryu, on 8 under, looking to recover from that drop shot last time out. She's leaning left after that tee shot. It's gone right, and it might well run through the green. Just stops on the cusp, and that is a long, long putt. Coming back down towards the pin from a good 35 feet or more. So she must two putt for par. Over at the par 4 eighth, here's Sung Ju-yin. Sung Ju-yin currently tied for fifth, even for the day. Bogey at the second, and then a birdie at the third. Janghana. Four shots off the lead with a long putt for birdie. Starts relatively straight. She's left that pretty short. So now a fiddly 6-footer to try and save her par. Has to capitalise on the more scorable holes. You wouldn't exactly call the 8th one of them. All depends on the tee shot, really, on that particular hole. I wouldn't say that too often with this golf course because there isn't that much rough, but it's certainly a hole where you need to find the fairway off that tee box to set up an opportunity for birdie. And that's going to drift to the high side of the cup and wide. So it will be a drop shot. That's disappointing from Janghana. After back-to-back birdies, she drops a shot. Here's Hyung Si Lin. After the excellent approach. And she has back-to-back birdies. She's had an eventful round so far, but it's three birdies in her last four holes. And she is making a move from the middle of the leaderboard. Just taking a look at some of the slightly earlier starters away from the top four or five to give you a sense of who's making a real push. After two rounds, incidentally, there is a cut. And the field is reduced as a consequence. And in terms of the movers so far during the course of the first sort of seven or eight holes for most, Ro Sung-hyu and Jong Sol-gi are both two under for the day and have moved to one under, so they are seven shots off the pace. Harmin Song and Lee So-yong are now on their back nine and both tied for eighth on two under, and they're two under for the day. So it's the final day of the SK Shielders SK Telecom Championship. And here is the par 3 7th. See, the pin is central right at the back of the green. Pak Ju-yong with a tricky up and down and not too much green to work with. That is a tremendous approach, and she will save her par. Obviously had a decent enough lie to be able to get enough purchase on the ball to stop it dead, or close to dead anyway. Just a really controlled pitch in, and she taps in to save her par. And she stays in second place on 6 under. Now the pressure on the leader with a long 2-putt to try and save her own par. Here's Park at the par 4 8th on 4 under. Tee shot giving her a really good angle of approach. The sand traps on the right, not really a factor from that position. Gone well past the pin though. We'll get a little bit of roll backwards, but she's probably going to have 35 feet. Pin just in front of that dip. From that sort of position, she shouldn't have any issues if she does go past it or to the right of it in terms of the ball picking up too much speed. As for Riho Ran, she finds herself right on the cusp of the green with a long 2-putt here. She's put that way left and it's going to run considerably past. Not only overhit that, but got the read completely wrong. And from the second it left her putter, it never looked like coming back towards the pin or stopping. So she'll now have a nerve-jangling putt to try and not only save her par, but prevent herself from dropping shots on back-to-back holes. It's a real test of the nerves. Ryuhei Ran has won once already this season in September at the Chosun Pro Celebrity. And let's see whether she can save her par. She doesn't. The tournament suddenly becomes open. Down the here, it's going to miss the corner of the cup on the left-hand side. Tricky downhill putt, nearly caught the edge. But it's back-to-back drop shots for Rihu Ran. And she falls to 7-under. Was in a similar sort of position, though, yesterday, where she was 2-over in the early part of her round and then just went on a birdie blitz through the back half of the front nine and the front half of the back nine. Here's Lee for what should be a simple tap-in. Slight bit of movement as she looks at it from left to right. And the birdie drops in. She moves to 4-under. So Ryu now only has a one-shot advantage on 7-under. Park Ju-yong on 6-under. Park Hyung-kyung on 4-under. And Hyun Si-lin is making a real charge with 3 birdies in her last 4 holes. Park's attempt at birdie nearly caught the left edge of the cup. But from distance, that's another measured putt. And she will no doubt tap in for par. Just looking ahead as far as the leading groups are concerned, the 8th, not the easiest of holes to score at. But we haven't seen many drop shots, not from the leadership group at that hole. Only Jang Ha-na, who did make a 5 there. The 9th is playing tough as well. 10 is a real scoring opportunity. That's the par 4. And then 11 is a par 5. There's 2 par 5s on the back 9. 15 as well. Star. 11 is the one that is maybe the kindest as far as scoring at this tournament is concerned. 11 and 1 are where a lot of the players have been able to cash in across the last 3 days. Here's Sung Yujin, her birdie attempt to move to 4-under. A lot of players misreading that putt. It's not a left to right. And because it starts straight and down on a slope, it picks up too much pace. So by the time it goes to the part of the green that looks like it's going to turn back, the ball is moving too fast. So you have to start that putt a little bit straighter. It is deceptive. And a number of the players have been undone by it over the course of the last few hours. So off we go to the 8th for the leading group. Lee Go-young, 330 metres this hole. Don't forget, after this event, not too many left in the season. 28th of November, Taiwan Women's Golf Open, the Hyun Sung Championship on the 5th of December, and then the Singapore Ladies Open to finish on the 12th of December. Lee with a birdie at the 8th. She's on three under. Sung to try and stay on 300 herself. And into the back middle of the cup with confidence. That's a good putt. Park to complete her par, barring an error, of course. And she taps that one in to stay at four under. So Ryu is one over for her round. Pak Ji-young and Lee Ga-young are one under for theirs. And Park Hyung-kyung also one under. So those chasing Ryu have gained two shots on her in terms of the swing since the beginning of the day. Ryu the only player in the field to shoot sub 70 on both days, a first round of 67, a second round of 69. A little further down the leaderboard, Lee So-young and Harmin Song both making moves. They're two under for the day. And Jing Sul-gi and Ro Seung-hyu are also two under for the day. First two players I mentioned are on two under overall, and the second two are on one under. So they are a little bit far back. But if Ryu drops another shot over the next one or two holes, then suddenly anyone around the three or four under mark is right back in this. As we see an excellent approach there. That landing zone to the right, just behind the pin, is the safest area to aim for. Much easier to stop the ball close on that side. Does leave a downhill putt, but nothing too severe from a short distance. Here's Pak in a good position in terms of visibility, just on the higher right side of the fairway as it doglegs round to the right over the sand. She just uses the slant on the side of the green there, landing it pin high and letting the ball do all the rest, and that's a clever shot. And two decent opportunities from about 10 foot for birdie for both players on the green, and that puts pressure on Ryu, who's a little bit further forwards here. Can she recover from back-to-back drop shots? That's brilliant. Lovely shot. Really aggressive right at the pin. And she's probably only about 7 feet away for a chance to gain back a shot. The 2020 Rookie of the Year is a very calm character. She won't be fazed if things tighten up. Doesn't give too much away in her demeanor. Here's Harming Song at the par 3 12th, this for birdie. And she makes it. So confirmation that Ri Haeran still leads and has an opportunity for birdie at the 8th to extend that lead. Pak Ji-young also in a position to potentially make birdie. A little bit further down the leaderboard, a cluster of players on 2s and 1s hoping to make a move in their back 9s. So welcome back. As we start to enter the business end Saturday, back end of the front nine for the leaders between 11 and sort of nine holes to go for most of the contenders. And all three of our leading group were within birdieable distances over on the 8th. Meanwhile, at the par 4 10th, here's Kim Hee-ji looking for her birdie. Down the hill from right to left, you can see the wind has started to pick up as well. That flag is really rattling in the cup. And it's just going to drift to the left at the last minute. So a wasted opportunity there to move to 3 under. After a measured approach, Kim remains on 2 under. She is 5 shots off our leader, who has a birdie opportunity. Here's Lee Go-yong. This is her birdie opportunity to get to 5. Just going to come in from left to right. She just started it. Probably only a matter of an inch too far to the left, and it didn't quite catch the corner of the cup on that left-hand side. And we will be watching those near misses with glee, because she's the closest of the lot. And it may well be an opportunity just to steady the ship for our leader and extend her lead to 2. Before that, though, here's Park Hyung-kyung at the par 4 ninth. The ideal tee shot, setting up this approach on one of the biggest greens of the golf course, and it is safer to try and bail out on that left hand side as she looks at it, the right of course of your pitcher. But she's overcooked that somewhat and now has a monster putt pretty much the length of the entire green to try and make an unlikely birdie. And here is Ryu, having seen the other two players miss their birdie opportunities. This one looks pretty straight as long as she hits it with enough pace. And that's exactly what she does. Brilliant putt. And the ship has indeed been steadied for now. Bogey, bogey, birdie. And she heads to the 9th with a big grin on her face. It's a 2-shot lead for Ryu Hai-ran. She moves to 8 under. Wind is practically bending that yellow flag stick. Doesn't, of course, affect this putt for Pak, but she's taken her time on the reed. Feels like there's going to be a bit of late movement here, but hit from that distance with pace, she's able to just guide it safely into the cup, and she stays on 6 under. But she's dropped a shot comparative to Ryu, who made a birdie on the same hole. And Lee for par here, can't afford any mistakes. The third player in this leading group. And she also taps in, as you would expect, for a solid par. Just behind our leading group, Lee Ga-young, Lee So-young, and Harmin Song are all in contention, with Lee So-young and Harmin Song in particular playing really well. They're both 3 under for their rounds. Here's Park Hyung with the putt that's the length of the entire green. Now, is this going to stop? It is. She got the pace absolutely perfect there. Just about the best you can do from that type of distance. Really well read. Took a big swing and got the pace absolutely perfect. And that should enable her to save her par. So a pretty uneventful front nine for Park. Just the one birdie and no drop shots. One under for the day. As we head to the par four ninth, 387 metres. And it hasn't been a hole that Rio has fond memories of. Made a par in her opening round and then a bogey yesterday. Bounced off to the right. And she's going to face a bit of a scramble already, not to throw away the birdie that she made at the previous hole. Just one birdie at this hole. That came from Anna Rin, who is currently tied for 21st on one over. A fair few bogeys as well, including John Solgi, who's two under for her round, but did drop a shot at the ninth today. Pack in second place, off the back of a par at the eighth. Driver in hand. And she dissects the fairway. Pretty much anyway, it has actually just ran off to the left-hand side. The fairway narrows at that part. But she should have a pretty good lie to try and hit the green with her approach. Sung Ju Yin down the hill from right to left, a very readable putt. She actually read that as left to right, and it did come in from the left at the angle of approach that she chose. It looked like he could have gone down the slope the other way. She, of course, though, has got a far better read from that position. And she didn't do too much wrong with the angle in or the line of the approach, but just didn't quite hit the ball with enough purpose to get that extra roll that might have seen her make a long distance birdie. Here's Hyung at the 10th, doesn't like it. Just pushed it slightly left, and that was a real opportunity from close distance to get in much tighter to the pin. Zhang second at the 10th now, 77 to the hole. Equally, much like the last shot, she's left that very short. Short and left, and it nearly rolled all the way back off the green. So two wasted opportunities there that really just required relatively routine golf shots. Lee completes her par for an in of 36. And confirmation of the leaderboard, Ryu Heiran, who may be in a little bit of bother at the ninth, leading Pat Ju-yong by 2 shots. Lee Ga-young with a high approach, which can be dangerous in breezy conditions, onto the safe central part of the green with a small amount of rollback. If you do go directly for the pin on that right hand side, it has to be spun in and stop pretty dead, otherwise the bounce can take it straight down the little ridge to the right of the pin and you can be off the green, and then there's an up and down with no real space to work with. And that's why a lot of the players are bailing out on the safer, flatter side of the green. And that's another good example of that there. Safe pin high approach. Here's Pak, who is also lining this one up to the left of the pin. Just creeps inside of Ryu's ball, but two very similar shots. As again, we just see the leaderboard there. Ryu leads by 2. Park and Lee, both Lees in fact, in contention as well. So back here at La Vie Espelle, it is the final round of the SK Shielders SK Telecom Championship. And we're at the par 4 ninth. And an opportunity here for Lee. Two Lees in contention, Lee Ga-young, but also Lee So-young as well, on 4 under and 3 under respectively. And that's just going to whistle past the left corner. An aggressive putt, but a dangerous one because chicken on the bone has been left, as they sometimes say in golf. In other words, plenty to do now the other way. If it caught the corner of the cup, it would have gone in, but instead, it's a bit of a challenge to come back the other way and complete par for Lee from maybe about 5 feet. Ninth is not an easy hole to get a birdie at. As I said earlier, Anna Rin, the only player to have done so today with this challenging pin position. Here's Ryu looking for back-to-back birdies from 20 feet or so. Starts that straight. It's just going to fade to the right. Just a fractional misread there. Needed to begin that a touch more to her left. But after a slightly shaky tee shot, she will be happy enough with a par. As we take a look at Kwak Bo-mi for the first time. And that's in for birdie. And she's flying and has been since the sixth. She did make a 7 at the fifth, but since then 4 birdies. And Kwak Bo-mi is now back at 1 under. One under, though, a long way off in terms of trying to win this thing for a player who only has 5 holes remaining. So Ryu missed her chance for a birdie. What can Pak Ju-young do? It's a dangerous pin position because straight after the pin, the green just starts to tilt down. Oh, that's in. The caddy, as far as the cameras are concerned anyway, rather ruining her highlight moment there by stepping in front. But it's a big smile. And that was hit with pace, one of those putts that has a risk-reward element. It either goes in or it runs 5 or 6 feet past. Pak, though, has tightened things up once again. She moves to 7 under. And is only 1 shot off the lead. Lee, who was equally as aggressive, but just missed the left corner of the cup, and now has this 4-footer back up the hill. And she does save her par. The sole advantage of it running past is that you will have the uphill putt, which is the preference for these players because you have a bit more control over it. Ryu should just be able to tidy up her par here. And does so from 1.5 feet. So an out for the leader of 36, but she's seen her lead cut. She has a 1-shot advantage with 9 holes remaining. An exciting finish that is shaping up to be a 2-horse race. But Lee and Park are also in contention as well. Ha-hyun and Jang are starting to run out of holes. So welcome back, and as you can see, the conditions are relatively pleasant but cool. High of 16 degrees. It will feel colder than that though due to the wind. 30% chance of rain. Ryu and Pak head-to-head in the final group. And Ryu, who's led from start to finish, the overnight leader for day one and day two. And she was able to extend her lead early doors with a birdie at the first, but her advantage has been cut to 1. She's on 8 under, Pak is on 7 under. And the players in the final group are at the 10th, so we're about, if it doesn't go to a playoff, 2 hours away from a conclusion. They're at the tee box of the 10th. Meanwhile, on the edge of the green is the penultimate group. And that's well weighted. Challenge here is not so much avoiding the sand, because the majority of players are sort of laying up with their second shot rather than trying to drive the green, giving themselves 70 odd meters and then chipping it up over the sand. Can be a little bit unsighted depending on where the lie is, although the fairway and the green are relatively flat, and that's what makes the 10th a reasonably safe par. We've only seen 3 drop shots today at this particular hole. Park Bo Kyom with a double bogey and Hyung Jung Ming with a bogey. Birdies though a little bit sparse, but most are coming away with a par at the 10th. And that's the best that Ryu will be looking for to protect her lead. A bit early to be playing conservative though from her perspective. It might have been different if she still had the three shot advantage. And it has actually been as big as four as well when she was at nine. And the best of the field behind her was only at five. So then you might be approaching a hole like the 10th and saying par is good enough. Here's Jang Hana, three under the very scorable par 5, 11th. And that will stop pin high, 18 feet away. Oh, magnificent. Park bouncing back from that 7 at the 10th with a birdie at the 13th. Just took all of the movement out of that putt with the pace that she executed it at. Pack for her birdie at the 10th. Fair bit of movement on this, from right to left as she looks at it. See, right at the last minute, the ball does turn, but she started it a bit too far wide. And assuming she taps that in, she'll have to settle for par. Kim Hee-ji, after the brilliant approach for birdie. And that's her third birdie with only one bogey of the round. Choosing to wear a tiger red on the final day. Jang Hana. 18-footer for birdie. Quite a straight putt, this one. Just drifts away to the right-hand side and rolls on a little bit too. So she's still got work to do if she's to make her par. Ryu, who's got one of the best short games on the tour, gives herself so many opportunities. And here's another one to extend her lead to two. Down the hill from 8 feet. She's missed it straight up out of the putt. She knew that the line was all wrong. So Pak and Ryu missing opportunities to a birdie the 10th. And it's as you were. Ryu still leading by one, with 8 holes remaining. Just looking a little bit further down the leaderboard, Park Kyung-kyung on 4 under. Also just parred the 10th. Lee Go-young looking to move to 5 under and right in contention, and she makes that putt. She's so cool with the putter in hand. 3 birdies for her in her round so far, and she moves to 5 under, only 3 shots off the lead. So when we go to the 11th, this has been a kind haul to many of the leaders, but particularly Ryu. Par 5. Just the one drop shot all day. And that came from Kim Julie, who is last. 5 over. Last, of course, from the players who made the cut for this final round. Pack in second place going first. 465 metres. Driver in hand. And that looks pretty safe to me. Right into the middle of the fairway. Any real danger off the tee is that sand trap to the right. The rough on the left-hand side isn't particularly thick. Good opportunity this potentially for Lee to try and cut into Ryu's lead. Another very good tee shot. Plenty of fairway to work with on this hole. Pretty decent as well from Ryu. So three really good safe tee shots right in the middle of the fairway. And all three of our final group with a good chance here of scoring well at the 11th. Park Hyun Kyung also at the 11th from the middle of the fairway. This is her second shot. Lee Dae-yeon with her third, just under 100 metres to the hole, and she went straight for the pin. Just left it a little bit short, and because the green dips there, that ball will roll a little bit further away than she would have liked. That was almost perfect. Sun Yu-jin, who is on 3 under. Is going to just stop on the little dip on the green, and that will be a nice uphill putt for birdie from relatively short distance. Over at the par 4 13th, Song with her second. Struggled yesterday with the putter. That's a good approach, and she'll be left with a 10-footer for birdie. Just fell off the pace though yesterday, having been hovering around the top of the leaderboard for the early part of the day. But the back nine let her down with the putter, and that's why she's out of contention. Rio leading by one. Leon 5 under, 3 shots off the pace. Park on 4 under is 4 adrift. And then a whole host of players are tied for 5th. Here's Jang Hana at the par 3 12th. She's gone right to the back of the green, which is the safe area, leaving a long 2-putt for par. Anything right at the pin, if it's short, will fall into the little dip on the green. And then it's a very tricky up and down from there. So here is the leader, Ryu. Most of the players laying up just to the left of the sand traps. It's ambitious to try and drive over and get on the green in 2. And Ryu pretty conservative, leaving herself about 80 odd meters to the pin. And then up and down from there, we'll see her make birdie. Lee's done the same. And those balls pretty much next to each other. I think Ryu is fractionally further ahead. Lee for birdie. Reasonably straight this one from 12 feet. Pulled that slightly to the left. So pars for Lee at 10 and 11. Off she goes to the 12th. And we go to the 13th now, the par 4. Sung at the 11th for a birdie to go to 6 under. Just whistles by the left edge of the cup. She'll be disappointed with that. Not a great deal of movement. Just misjudged it. And a wasted opportunity by Sung. She stays at 3 under. Choye Yana, first look at her at the par 4 13th. This is for a birdie. With that bright pink ball. Will it prove the lucky pink ball? It will. Super putt. And she is now at 1 under. Having recovered from an early wobble at the 2nd. Jang Hana for a long birdie. This one will start left and then straighten, and that looked online right until the final few rolls. Very well measured putt, and I'm lucky not to come away from the hole with a birdie. So the early starters are not too far off finishing, most of them still towards the back of the leaderboard. I'll update you on that in a moment. Kim knocks that one in. Kim 3 under for the tournament, 2 under for the day. Birdie at the 12th. And Kim Rian, the other Kim who looked like she might contend after a 68 yesterday, but a 76 in the first round. She a little bit lower down the leaderboard, is on even par. Certainly took the momentum though from yesterday, did Kim Rian into her front nine with birdies on the second and the third, but since then she's failed to clock another birdie and has dropped 2 shots. So I think it's fair to say that tied for 17th on even par, she's out of contention. And really anyone now who is on 3 under or less is starting to run out of holes. Pack in a spot of bother. Interesting to see what that lie looks like. Hyung-Si Lin for birdie at the 12th. See if this turns from right to left. Great putt. And that's a birdie for her. Not an easy putt. And a strong response after a bogey at the last hole. Bounces back with a birdie and moves to 3 under. Lee Ga-young on 5 under. What's her approach like at the 11th? A little bit short. And that is going to be a tough ask if she is to walk away with a birdie. Ryu, who laid up to the left of the green. So this now her approach to try and get somewhere close for birdie. Goes right at the pin, but just stops a little bit short. But it will stay on the higher ground of the green there, rather than rolling backwards. And again, outside chance of birdie, but should be guaranteed a par. As we take another look at the leaderboard, Ryu leading pack by 1. Lee Ga-young hanging around, and Park Hyung-kyung not out of contention either. So into the back nine, the business end of the tournament, and here's Pak just off the fairway at the SK Shielders SK Telecom Championship. Pak 1 shot off the lead. A little bit short. Nothing too severe though. Would have liked that just to take an extra roll or two, and then she could have taken full advantage of the downhill slope. Ryu in a better position at that hole, and we'll be back there shortly. But here's Zhang at the par 4 13th, her second shot. Right into the heart of the green. Leon 5 under. This is for birdie from distance. Not an easy up and down. Never looked like seriously challenging the pin, but close enough that she'll be confident of completing her par from just a couple of feet. Huang Zhongmi is 3 over, and this is her second shot. So playing for position now rather than the championship. And that's aggressive right at the pin. Excellent shot, pin high. Judge the distance brilliantly. And she'll have a good opportunity to move to 2 over for the tournament. So pack for birdie to tie on 8 under. And she makes it. A steely putt. And we have joint leaders, albeit Hai Ran still has to finish the hole. So could restore parity. But for now, we are tied at the top of the leaderboard. Pat Ju-young, who is 3 under for her round, 8 under for the tournament. And the momentum is with her. Ryu, though, can make the tie last just a matter of moments if she sinks this from 10 feet or so. And she does. 2 excellent mid-range putts from Pak and Ryu. And psychologically, that is absolutely massive. Brilliant putt. Means that Ryu protects her one shot advantage. Is Kim Hee-ji, the par 4 14th, second shot, just over 150 metres to the hole. In a good position here to attack the pin at the back of the green. Really more in the back centre of the green, there is a little bit behind it. But that's quite short, and she faces a long putt for birdie. Lee Ga-young saves her par, which was a must to keep her slim tournament chances alive. Still 7 holes, of course, but had she dropped a shot there, the gap to Ryu would have been 5. Let's take a look at the 12th, which doglegs round to the right. All the sand is on that left-hand side. ...152 meter par 3. Downward slope right in front of the pin. Anything to the left will be a downhill putt. Quite some speed. Harming Song, Kim Hee Ji, and Hyun Si Lin have all made birdies at this hole today. As has Kwak Bo Mi and also Lee Hyo Rin. And it will be Pak to step up first, having briefly tied the lead, only for Rio to also make a birdie at the 11th. Two really good putts by both players. See there that Pak Ju-young doing most of her damage at the par fours, but she's two over on the par threes across the tournament. Needs to try and rectify that here. It's a safe tee shot. Important if you're going to go deep and into the center that you don't end up catching the little dip in the middle of the green, otherwise your ball can run down and then it makes it a whole lot harder with the putter to try and save your par. An outside chance of birdie there. Ryu's tee shot goes to the right. It's pin high and about 30 feet away. Slightly easier putt though than Pak will have. As Huang just misses the left corner of the cup. Or the left rim, I should say. Circle doesn't technically have corners. As Kim has this long putt for birdie, the line looks good and it drops. A spectacular long range putt by Kim, who now has two birdies in her last three holes. Aggressive play on the back nine and she moves to four under. Lee Hyo Rin is about to complete her tournament. She's five over. So the early starters are now finishing. Leaves the putt short. It's been a frustrating day for Lee. Seven at the 15th, a six at the sixth. And her day is done. In with a 38 and out with a 39 for a round of 77. And she finishes the tournament six over. Also at the 18th, Lee Gi. And that's a positive way to finish. She holds her par. in of 37 and out of 36. So a 1 over 73 for Lee G. Papem, and she is currently tied for 22nd on 2 over. Confirmation of the top of the leaderboard. The leader's about to putt on the par 3 12th. Lee Guy Young for a birdie. Just turned mid putt and never straightened. Lee So Young at the par 3 17th for a long birdie. That might just have enough on it to drop. Agonizingly close. Got the line absolutely perfect, but not quite the length to match. So she stays on 2 under with just the 18th to play. Heading back then to the leading group here. Pack to putt first for her birdie. Sunk a mid-range one last time out at the 11th to birdie the par 5. That just took a slightly awkward roll. And she'll have to mark up and then tap in for par. Gets the nod to play through out of turn and mops up for a par that keeps her at 8 under. So another opportunity here for Ryu to maybe give herself a bit of comfort. Sung, who was torn between clubs, 131 to the hole. And that was a good choice of club in the end. She's cleverly used the undulations on the green to bring that one into within about 15 feet. Park Young Kyung. A couple of birdies so far at this par 4. Going to be an ask, though, now to make it a hat-trick of birdies across the 3 days as her ball runs through the green. She'll still no doubt use the putter from there, though. So here's the leader with a bit of a freebie after Pax missed her birdie opportunity. Good 25 feet or so away. But quite a straight putt. She nearly made it as well. Whistles past. without catching the right lip. Zhang safely onto the green on the left hand side. And a mid range putt to try and grab a birdie as we watch to see whether Ryu can just complete her part. And she can, sinks them with her eyes shut all day long. Very consistent putter. We go to the 13th. It's a really intriguing par 4, 338 meters. Sand left and right at the front of the green. Pretty safe landing zone. Quite a lot of fairway to work with. Interesting is that pin position. Right at the back, and anything short can run quite steeply down towards the sand traps. Again, very consistent off the tee box. And that's straight down the middle of the fairway. She has the momentum, 3 under for the day. Ryu has wobbled somewhat, but is still 1 under for her round and 9 under for the tournament, leading by 1. How important could her birdie at the 11th prove to be? 7 birdies at this very scorable par 4, 13th, and only 2 bogeys. The leader's tee shot also nicely onto the fairway. Kim Hee-ji is making a bit of a run. She's at the par 5 15th. This is her third shot, just 85 meters in. And that's right at the pin. Lovely approach. And there could very well be another birdie coming. Song as well, in similar vein, slightly further behind, but another aggressive, good approach right at the pin. The wind has died down and the players taking advantage with those kind of approaches. You can see from the flags that the breeze much, much calmer than it was about an hour or so ago. Jiang for a much needed birdie if she's to try and go on a surge. But at 3 under, she's probably too far behind. That maybe was her last chance if she wanted to set something up to try and contend. John Soji is already in the clubhouse with a 70. That's a 2 under round, and that's the lowest clubhouse score we've seen for the day. Park completes her par and stays at 4 under. Here's Lee at the 13th. All three players in that final group in a good position here to capitalise. That's a short approach though, and a birdie from there is going to be difficult. Maybe just needed a club more. It's going to find its way off the green, or at least temporarily anyway. Rolls it off the top of the bank and then gains a few feet back onto the top right of the green. And that's not an easy putt because these greens are a little bit deceptive and undulating. And also the downhill will make that a pretty fast putt as well. So it's advantage Pak, who's the closest of the lot. And Pak has angled that in nicely. A controlled approach. Maybe would have liked it a fraction closer, but that's a good opportunity at birdie. And if she makes it, she could find herself tied for first. Song for birdie at the 15th. She's out of contention, even par for the tournament. Kept that on the high side and it passes the hole. Kim, who has the bit between her teeth, and that's a birdie to move to 5 under. And look at this. 3 birdies in her last 4 holes. Still with some work to do if she is to challenge. Ryu leading Pak by one. Kim making a move, tied for third with Lee. And Park Hyun-kyung, 5 shots off the pace. And just about still in contention, but running out of holes. So we head to the par 4 13th, and Lee with an uphill putt that flattens towards the pin. Good line. And that nearly stood a chance of creeping in. She's one of the top players on tour at those longer putts. Judges pace really well. And she knows that was agonizingly close. Taps it in one-handed. I haven't really seen anybody miss the short gimmies, which you would expect, but sometimes the nerves can get to players, and at other times there can just be a deceptive amount of turn with even the shortest of putts, but not so much on this course. Over at the par 4 14th, Park. Her approach is just going to skid off the green and into the sand. Looks like the lie is okay. Got a fair amount of bunker to work with, but not too much green to get that up and down. So she's going to have to chip it out with high elevation and try and stop it dead. Here's the leader for birdie at the par 4 13th. So left to right putt. Just drift away in the final few feet. Pretty cryptic green, this one. And Ryu Hae-ran remains on 9 under. Pak is going to have an opportunity to tie. Taking a long time here to read this. Crouching down for the second time, having another look. Now she stands over the ball. The importance of this, obvious at this stage of the tournament. This to tie the lead again, which she did fleetingly at the 11th before Ryu made a birdie of her own. Starts left, straightens, the line looks good, it's in. Excellent putt. And we're tied again. Pak moves to 9 under. Birdie at the 13th. And a two-way tie at the top of the leaderboard in what looks like being a two-horse race. The momentum is with Pak, but the experience is with Ryu. Even though she was only a rookie in 2020, she has the experience in the sense that she's won this year and recently at the Chosun Pro Celebrity. in the Sanders Park, with, as I said before, not too much green to work with here. The lilac's okay. Couldn't get any real spin on that ball by coming underneath it and hit it a little bit heavy. And the fat contact means that she could be in danger of dropping a shot. As our final group reached the 14th, the par four. So five holes remaining. And locked on 9 under, Pak and Ryu. Pak now 31 and had a birthday actually relatively recently at the end of October. Meters this par four. Really one of the harder holes on the golf course. We saw earlier Jun Yu Ri making 8. And we've only seen a couple of birdies today, one of which came from Kim Hee-ji, who has had those birdies at the 12th, the 14th and the 15th to move to 5 under, 4 shots off the pace. Hyun Si Lin makes the birdie at the 15th. And she's now on 4 under for the tournament and 2 under for the day. Park. With a confident putt. Here's Jang at the par 5 15th. This is for birdie down the hill from about 10 feet. And that's a good putt. Held her nerve well there for her first birdie of the back nine. Just 3 holes to play for her. Towards the lower end of the leaderboard. Players starting to finish. Huang Zhongmi to get to 2 over for the tournament at the 15th. Just drifted away at the last minute on the low side of the hole. We've had our first sub 70 round from those early finishers. Ro Sung Hyu with a 68 that included 5 birdies, and she's tied for 6th on 3 under, 4 under for the day. back to the leader. Her second shot from the middle of the fairway. Quite conservative into the centre of the green. 30 to 35 feet for birdie remain. See here that Pack, the other co-leader, has got a really good view of the pin. Just 121 metres to go for the co-leader. And lots of options here to go right at the flag, left or right. Should be disappointed with that. Left it a little bit short. Possibly caught between clubs. So the players have made their way up to the green. Pack, as ever, methodic, assessing her options. Relaxed, perhaps instinctive as well in her putting action. Tends to be a lot quicker, a bit more decisive. Pack, more of a scientific mind. Routine though that works for individual players, different styles, but the same result at the moment. Two players locked on 9 under, and the rest of the field probably too far back. So Ryu goes first for her birdie. The line looked okay, but it just whistles past the hole. And that will be a 2.5 footer for par.
pack to take the outright lead, which psychologically against a player that's led wall to wall would be big. Ryu, the round one and round two leader. Pack doesn't like that straight up out the putt turn too early. And she'll have to make do with par as well. After this, the par 5 15th, which, much like the 11th, definitely has scoring there for the taking. And then the very tricky par 4 16th, the risk-reward 17th, and then the idyllic 18th to complete the tournament. Assuming, of course, by the end of the 18th that the scores aren't tied, otherwise we will need a playoff. Lee at the 14th, that was a good effort from the edge of the green. And she completes her par to stay at 5 under, 2 under for the day. Ryu for her par. No problems once again. She's looking relaxed out there, even though the momentum is with Pak. Oh, Pak's missed it. How costly could that be? Big surprise. Again, looked long and hard at it, but it just turned. Tricky downhill putt, but one that you would expect her to make. And Ryu, even with only a par, is back to the outright leader as Pak unexpectedly drops a shot. You can see the disappointment and frustration on her face. Offers up a wry smile. But she'll be really disappointed with that. So here's a look at the 15th. Par 5. And one where the players have scored well today. 505 metres. Landing zone with a fair amount of sand to the left. Tee shots to the left do give the option of coming over the sand traps and cutting the corner. there, a heart-shaped green. Sand to the right and the left. And the pin pretty much slap bang in the middle. It's Ryu to tee off first. She's pushed that to the left. So it's already advantage pack on this hole. Pack happy enough with that, straight down to pick up the tee, which is usually a sign that a golfer thinks they've hit the ball cleanly. Still slightly left as well. Over at the par 4 16th, one of the hardest holes on this golf course, Jang Hanna's second. Is brilliantly executed to set up a really good chance at birdie. Park Kyung-kyung must sink birdie if she is to somehow challenge, and it just didn't turn. And you can understand why at this stage of the tournament players are giving it that bit of extra roll. So frustrating as a golfer when you leave the ball short and don't even give it a chance at the pin. And in stroke play, that's natural. But at this point, you almost want your players to be adopting a match play approach. And much like the Solheim Cup and the Ryder Cup, you just want to see them give it a chance of at least reaching the pin. When, of course, you are trying to chase down the leaders with limited holes, that extra aggression, very much needed. If someone around the 4 or 5 under mark is going to eat into the current leaders. Kim's tee shot, pretty aggressive, but it will run considerably past the pin. Now Sung for birdie at the par 5 15th. Nearly dropped. I think she thought that was in. Was crouching down to celebrate that. And it just stopped short. And you can see the frustration on her face. She stays at 3 under. Zhang at the 16th on 4 under. This could take her to 5 under. Started that too wide, and that's disappointing. Really needed that. Had she gone to 5 under and then finished birdie, could have made things interesting. So here is the leader at 15. Her second shot. Not in as much bother off the tee as she feared when she was leaning left. And that's another clean hit into the middle of the fairway. It is a big fairway, so there is some margin for error. Now Pak, who is 3 under for the day, but rather threw away the last hole, missing a short par putt. And that means that Ryu goes back into a one-shot lead. Park for par. So she remains on 4 under, but had a real opportunity for a birdie at that hole. Lee Dar-yeon, also for par at 15 from 2.5 feet, and that rims out. She just hit it a little bit too hard. So a 6 at 15, a rare 6 at the 15th. Lee So-mi, Kwak Bo-mi, Jun Yuri, the players that also have sixes. And then Lee Hyo-rin came away with a seven at this hole. third at 15. Got a good angle coming over the sand trap. And that's the sort of focal point. She's overcooked that one though. And it will roll onto the bank into the second cut of rough. That could have been a lot worse. But a very difficult up and down now to try and save her par. Lee with her third. And that is nicely weighted. And she could be in a position to move to six. This, you feel, is a really big shot for Rui. Ryu, if she can get this close, just could give herself a little bit of comfort. Three holes remaining after this one. Oh, that's wonderful. That might be the shot when she looks back at it that really ends up paving the way to win this tournament. Perfectly executed. And with packing trouble, a birdie here could put one hand on the trophy. Here's Kim again, penultimate hole, the par 3, 17th. Straight up out of that putt, didn't like it at all, and that's why. Just completely misjudged the read. I think she might have even topped the ball slightly. Lee So-mi. This is for bogey at the 18th as she finishes up for the day. Misses it. And a sad way to finish, in all probability, with a double bogey if she sinks that short putt. Song at 17 for birdie. And she makes it. Her first birdie on the back nine. And she's one under for the tournament. Park for birdie as well to finish with a flurry at 18 from about 8 feet. And in that one goes, so Park Bo-kyum with three birdies on the back nine. That's seven at the 10th, blotting her card to some extent. Park Bo-kyum, other than the seven, has had a really good round.
bridge, yeah, come.
Buddy.
Here's Ryu, her tee shot at the par 4 16th. And continues her high fairway percentage. Doesn't have to do anything too aggressive. is Huang at the par 3 17th. Putt from short distance for birdie. And she's back at 3 over. Brilliant tee shot, one of the best that we've seen. And here we go with the final stages, and it's ruse to lose. 10 under, 2 under for the day, and 3 clear of Pak, who crucially at that last hole dropped a shot, with Ryu making a birdie, so a swing of 2. Lee's going well, 3 under for the day. So heading towards the end of the day, and the final round always starts a little bit earlier because it has to factor in the potential extra time needed should a playoff arise. And twice we've had a tie at the top of the leaderboard between Ryu and Pak, but now Ryu has pulled away and is the firm favourite to see this out, because Pak is running out of holes and is going to have to be very attack-minded and aggressive and take a few risks if she is to get back into this. Here's Song for birdie at the 18th. Always looked offline. And she will tap that in for par to complete her day. Just a reminder that after this, we have the Taiwan Women's Open, the Hyosung Championship, and the Singapore Ladies Open before the season finishes in December. Kim Hee-ji finishing on 4 under for the tournament. Song for her part. And if she makes this, she will end on minus 1. 1 under. A productive week for Song. Rounds of 70, 72 and 73. Lee trying to go right at the pin. It will just skid past it though. And that is a downhill 25 footer or so to try and get to 7 under. Now Ryu with this 3-shot advantage. Doesn't need to go right at the pin here. Pars will do very nicely. But feeling confidence. And that is an incredible approach.
brilliant ball control, high elevation approach. Luckily for her, the wind has died down and slightly able to stop that, only a matter of 4 or 5 feet away from the hole. Can Pack respond? She can also, a very good shot. But she has to bet up Ryu. And every hole, just making a birdie won't mean anything if Ryu does the same. So confirmation that Ryu at the 16th, leading by 3, and both Ryu and Pak with excellent birdie opportunities to come. And if Ryu makes another birdie, that should just about be that. So here's Lee for birdie, with an even closer putt from Ryu to come. Must make for Lee if she is to still challenge, and that's why she treated it like a match play putt and made sure that the ball reached the hole, missed it to the right, and still a bit of work to do to try and make her par. Lee for a birdie at the par 317. And that one drops. So she's recovered really well from the 6th at 15 with back-to-back birdies. Pack for a birdie. She also cannot afford to miss, and she doesn't. So that just puts a bit of pressure now on Ryu. Pak back at 8 under, Ryu on 10 under, but an even closer putt than the other two players in her group to try and move to 11 under and protect a 3-shot advantage. And that was unlucky. That could have easily caught the right lip of the hole and just dropped in. Chun-Si Lin will finish with a par. Lee for par, having really gone for it to try and get to 7 under. Her charge is now over as far as the championship is concerned. She should finish third, but maybe not, because she's going to drop her shot. Can't afford to drop that shot and fall to 5 under. But if she drops another, then she'll suddenly be tied for third with Kim Hee-ji, Hyun-Si Lin, Lee Da-yeon, and Yang Ha-na, all on 4 under. Kim Hee-ji and Hyun-Si Lin have already finished. And Kim Hee-ji with a 69, second best round of the day, behind Ro Sung-hyu, who's in with a 68. So a big moment here. Ryu for birdie from just a few feet downhill, and in it goes. Just doesn't look nervous at all. Such a good putter.
so composed out there. And after Pack temporarily cut the lead to two, it's back up to three again. And crucially, only two holes remain. Jang Hana finishes with a par. And this is Huang Zhongmi for her par. And she makes no mistake. 78 though in round three after encouraging first rounds of 70 and 71. But a frustrating afternoon. As far as me is concerned. A lot of the damage done on the front nine with fives at the first, the second and the third, I should say, and then a five at the fourth, which was a double bogey, and then bogeys also at the seventh and the eighth. As we go to the par three 17th. Safely into the middle of the green, a conservative tee shot there from Rui. She just doesn't need to do anything other than keep her cool now, and she will win this tournament. Pack, on the other hand, needs to try and go right at the pin here. Young, the 31-year-old who turned 31 in October. Doesn't look like she likes the look of this. Pretty similar position to where Ruru's ball is. As you can see, the lead is still three. Birdies for Ruru and Pak at the last hole, the 16th. And I think especially when everyone saw the wind in the early and middle part of day one, if you'd have said that a player would be on 8 or 9 under after the final day, most would have said that that would have been good enough to win, but it looks like that will be the gauge for second place, because Ryu has got into double figures under par, and 11 under, it's an excellent score. Conditions have subsided though since that first day, which, even though the pins were a bit more kind, was the hardest day to actually play in, particularly in the morning. Pack, as you can see, can't sink the birdie. Certainly gave it a good go though. Sung, hoping to get to four under. That's not going to turn, so she'll stay on three under. Still good enough though for a top 10 finish. Rounds of 72, 69 and 72. Ryu, high ran for birdie from distance. She judged the pace here really well. And that will be another surely simple par, allowing her to take a three-shot advantage to the final hole. And she can relax and start to celebrate, barring an incredible turnaround. In it goes. And we're surely looking at the champion right here. A good score as well, like I said before, considering the conditions. Best score across 3 days that we've seen was back in 2017 from Jihan Sol, who carded a 198, the only sub 200 rounds over the 3 days, 66, 66 and 66 for her 4 years ago. Here's Lee for birdie, having hit the best of the three tee shots. And that's into the middle of the cup. And she's back at six under. And that solidifies her position in third. Lee Dae-yeon. To move to five under. It's quite a straight putt, that one. But she just thought it would turn towards the end and it didn't. Pack for par, all a bit immaterial now because she's highly likely to finish second and not drop to third or climb to first. Twice she was level with Ryu, but now she heads to the 18th. Three shots behind. The 18th is a 382 meter par four with water on the right. Large sand trap as well, and two smaller ones by the landing zone. Dog legs round to the left, can come over the sand or the water to cut out a bit of distance, or play it safe to the left, and that's what we'll see Ryu do with the three shot advantage. Undulating green. Pin is in the centre. Anything to the right that's short could find the sand or the water. Lee to go first at the last. Aiming that left and nicely onto the fairway. Couple of sixes on this 18th from Lee So-mi and Kim Julie. Ryu Hai-ran with a birdie-birdie record at this hole. And that's safely off the tee box. Onto the fairway. And she now knows, having avoided the water, that the trophy will be hers. And we'll bring you that trophy presentation as well, probably in about 20 minutes or so. Tee shot also excellent. So up the final three walk. Lovely approach visually here with the water shimmering on the right. And at first it will be Lee Ga-young. Could, if there's a two-shot swing, finishes the runner-up. Just short of the green, but with the pin at the front, she could potentially have a putt or a little chip towards the pin to try and make bogey, or she could be a bit more conservative and just get up and down for par from there. The leader. I think it's fair to call her the champion as well, especially now because she's on the green, and that one will just curve back pin high, and she will have a 20-footer for birdie to really put the icing on the cake. Ryu Hai-ran is 32nd in the Rolex rankings. Pack's second shot, she's got a lovely high vantage point, so a really good view of the pin. She just cleverly uses the downward undulation on the green to bring that one in. That's a nice little shot, and she could well finish with a birdie as well, but we'll have to settle for the runners-up spot. This will be Ryu's fourth win on this particular tour. This season, she as I said earlier, won the Chosun Pro Celebrity in 2020. She won the Samdasu Masters, and she also won the same tournament, the Samdasu Masters, in 2019. Second place finish this season at the Lotte Open, but this will be the first time she's ever won two KL PGA events in the same season. So it will be Lee to go first. Of course, Ryu will also make headway in the money and the points rankings as well. Park Min-ji leading the points. Jang Han-na has got the best scoring average so far. And Park Min-ji also is the money leader as well. This event has a billion KRW. Ryu waiting patiently with ball in hand. She can afford a full smile now on the green and with a 3-shot lead. And she's waiting to sink her final putt and then get those celebrations started for her second win of the season on this tour. First, though, it's Lee from the edge of the green is choosing to putt. This is for par. And she will unfortunately drop a shot and fall to, if she sinks this, 5 under. Just lining up her putt. Pack, though, to go first. This for birdie to move to 9 under. Down the hill. Fades away on the short side of the hole. Thank you. So it's all about Ryu, who knows that she is the champion and has secured her second win of the season. Looks like she might even grab a birdie to finish. Ryu standing over this birdie putt to wrap up victory. Oh, she almost sunk it as well. Agonizingly close. She and the crowd enjoyed that one. That would have been a brilliant way to finish. But instead, she'll have a tap in for par to complete a hard-earned victory. She held her nerve on the back nine. She was challenged by Pak at times. She was twice level with Pak. But the 11th proved a key birdie. And after gaining that shot at the par five and seeing a swing of two, Ryu just didn't look back. Liam Pak, I think, here will just clear the way for Ryu to tap in last. Lee's furthest away anyway, so she was always going to go first. And she sinks that, drops a shot at the hole, but finishes in third on five under. So a productive week for her. Even though Pak is closer, as you can see from the two markings, she will just tap in and then allow Ryu the victory parade. Pak for par. In it goes. She finishes second. And she knows there was a real opportunity. Missed one short par putt at the 11th when Ryu made a birdie and that two-shot swing proved crucial. So here is Ryu for her par to wrap up victory, her second of the season. And it is all smiles for Ryu Hai-ran, who makes a par at the last and finishes on 11 under. Three under round. An excellent wall-to-wall victory. She's doused in water, as is the tradition. It is victory for Ryu, the first time she's won two events in the same season on this tour. She is in imperious form at the moment, having also won the Chosun Pro Celebrity in October. So it's not just two victories this tour, this season. It's two victories in 2 months. And she can dry herself off with an official KLPGA towel that says 2021 winner, and then receive her trophy. Here is the final putt. Ryu Hai-ran wins it by three shots ahead of Pak Ju-young, with Lee Ga-young in third. And then Kim Hee-ji, Lee Da-yeon, Shun Si-lin and Jang Ha-na tied for fourth. Park Hyun-kyung also in the mix there as well, all on four under. But after leading from round one with a 67 and then adding a 69 to it, Hai-ran completes a wall-to-wall victory, which we don't see too often on this tour. And the three under round as well ensures that Ryu makes it three rounds of sub 70 as well. So really impressive. And we'll bring you the trophy presentation in just a moment. confirmation there of the money list. And Ryu is up to fifth. Park Min-ji isn't going to be caught. See there, Lee Ga-young moves to 14th, and Pak is in 17th. So as you can see, we are ready to hand over to the presentation ceremony. The red carpet is out. The officials are in place. And our winner, Ryu Hai-ran, about to be presented with her trophy. Ryu Hai-ran collecting her trophy after that three-shot victory over Pak Ju-young, finishing on 11 under, rounds of 67, 69, and 69. She gets a red jacket to boot. Second win this season. And she's in excellent form heading into the final three events of the 2021 tour. There's the prize money in cold hard cash. Something to take to the bank. Certainly beats a giant novelty check, doesn't it? Just having all the notes there. So plenty for Ryu to take home the trophy. Cash. The winner's banner. She climbs in those money and points rankings. So Ryu Hai-ran is the winner of the SK Shield SK Telecom Championship. An imperious performance she led from start to finish in terms of being the overnight leader on day one, day two, and now the champion on day three. Congratulations to her. 11 under, she finishes on three shots clear of Pak Ju-jong, with Lee Ga-young in third place on five under for the tournament. Thanks for joining us, and do join us again next time. Three events to go. Up next, the Taiwan's Women's Golf Open, followed by the Hyosung Championship, and then finally the Singapore Ladies Open. But for now, congratulations to Ryu Hai-ran, and thanks again for joining us.